It is 12:01 p.m. Central Time on Monday, August 8th, 2016. I hope you guys are doing good. I just wanted to show you something that's developed out here in the United States since last night's update. First of all, we're looking at, let's go turn on the past 24-hour USGS feed. And you'll see a 2.4 earthquake is listed over in southeast Illinois. And this is fairly rare. We don't normally see much earthquake activity in this location in Illinois. If you were on just a little bit ago, you probably saw me already doing the screen caps on this. But let's take this back and just show you where it is in relation in the United States. Okay, here's Missouri. Here's where I live. And then over to the east, we have our earthquake epicenter, and we'll zoom in here. I marked it as 2.4 earthquake, August 8th, 2016. And you'll be able to make out that we've got multiple frack wells nearby. And here's some examples right here. So we go across, we've got oil wells, more oil wells, frack wells, oil wells. You can even make out the shadow of the pump on here, even though it's kind of low resolution. Here's more fracking wells. And I don't know if we have a street level view. Let me just quickly see if we do have a street level view on this. No street level view. Of course, it's out in the middle of rural Illinois. It's not like there's going to be much street level views. But again, we've got more over to the east. So if you guys are curious, you can come over and check out this location. They started fracking here many years ago. And this is the spot where the largest earthquake to strike in Missouri, Illinois, in the New Madrid seismic zone occurred. Several actually have struck here over the past several years into the 5.0 range. So as we're just, and pardon the cat, guys, she's completely overwhelmingly meowing today. And I find that to be not a coincidence because of the earthquake activity striking here in the Midwest today. Seems like animals are sensitive to those things, and I've noticed a correlation between when my cat starts to freak out and meow and earthquake activity in the Midwest. And now right across in Illinois, we have a near 2.5 earthquake. But just be aware that that's going on, and it's at a fracking operation. There is no doubt about that. So if you live in Illinois, just be aware your fracking operations are not immune to the seismic activity when it's pressing to the East Coast. And we've been watching this happen for the last several days, pressing to the East Coast. So just be aware that's going down. That's why I went and looked it up. I wanted to show you guys. Like I said, most people don't know what's in Illinois right there. And I would dare say it's not wise to be fracking the New Madrid seismic zone or the Wabash Valley seismic zone. It's just not a good idea. As a matter of fact, they probably should close those wells, fill them all with concrete completely all the way down, and be done with it. Because the amount of money you're going to make out of this probably is not that much. And the risk that you're putting your population into and the people in the area because of making it seismic prone in a already seismically prone area, just not a good idea in general. And hopefully they'll get that fixed at some point in the future. So much love, guys. Much love. Just jumping in to show you that. Isn't that interesting? Right? I mean, you know, Illinois fracking, you don't normally think about it. I wouldn't have known if I wouldn't have gone and looked up earthquakes there before. It's not like they advertise it, you know? So cheers, I'll be back.